Hello everyone, I hope that you're having a great morning so far. So today's video is going to be really interesting, so please hit the like button before I even continue. And if you haven't subscribed, then go ahead and also make sure that you have done it, because I found out that YouTube has a tendency to unsubscribe you sometimes. So just go down and make sure that you are subscribed. So let's start with the video. So I've always thought that when I argue with someone, it's going to go something like this. You know you're ugly, right? Have you looked in a mirror before you came and talked to me?
Duh. And are your glasses working? Because if they did, you'd be able to see that I'm gorgeous.
Please. Yeah, I'd call you stupid, but that would be an insult to stupid people.
Excuse me?
Yeah. Did I stutter? You heard me. Now, let's be honest. If you're walking into a conversation like this, when both people, like, wanna, to put it simply, wanna rushiana matusi in insult, you both look ridiculous. And if no one's gonna see it, you both look stupid, because you are both in the wrong. You both are arguing. If you both retaliating, you know, so you both in the wrong. And if someone of a higher authority, it could be a teacher, it could be a boss, walks in on you arguing with someone like that, then you're just both going to be punished, because you're both in the wrong. And I've always thought that I have like a sick comeback. You know, if anyone told me like I'm ugly, I'd be like, look in a mirror, or I'm not a mirror. Or if someone told me I'm stupid, I'd be, what would I do? No, what do I think I would do? I thought that I would have this like cool comeback. I'd be like, what? Sorry, I don't speak silly, or I don't speak idiot. Because I thought like I'd be this cool kid, the cool comebacks. Then I realized like, what if I keep quiet? What will that other person do? Like, what are you doing? And it will probably go like something like this. You know you're ugly, right? And you're stupid too. Are you deaf? Hello, can you hear me? Are you gonna say anything? Now look at you. Do you realize how ridiculous you look? Not the person who's quiet, the person on this side. Look at you. Look at you insulting someone who's not even saying something. You look like you're talking to a wall. Like, it's so... The point is, when you keep quiet in this particular situation, it does not mean that you're weak. It just shows that you're more mature. And of course, the person retaliating, like this person, looks utterly ridiculous. And if a person of higher authority walks in into this particular situation, of course people would take this person's side, because they are quiet. Of course they are the victim, and in that situation you do look like the more mature person, because you are. And it's, you shouldn't just do this because you want to look like mature and everything. It should come like from like inside you. Like you feel like you are mature and you're not going to engage in like a silly petty fight. Let me ask you, if you respond to them, if someone tells you, let's say like you're stupid, then I'm like, what? Shh, wait, listen. That's the sound of nobody caring. If you say something like that, then what will you gain? Will you become number one? Will you become the president? Will you find a cure of cancer? Will you find a cure of COVID? Will you cure COVID? What will happen? What will you gain? Tell me one thing. And chances are, you probably will even lose. So there's no point in doing it. You won't gain anything. And the Bible even says it is to the credit of a wise man to ignore an insult. Keeping quiet. Keeping quiet doesn't mean you're weak. It doesn't mean that you can't, like, you know, it doesn't mean that you can't, like, fight back. It doesn't show that you're weak. it actually shows that you're like the bigger person. And it's not only in this situation, maybe like in fighting, like physical fighting. I know the Bible says turn your other cheek, but you shouldn't, like, you know, let's say someone throws a punch. I feel as a Christian, you should block what they are throwing. You should block, but you shouldn't hit back. Are you understanding? Like, you should block their hits, but you shouldn't actually, like, hit back with the intention to hurt them. Unless self-defense, that's understandable. But you shouldn't. Or if someone is, what do people say, does you dirty, like, they wrong you, don't revenge. It just shows that you're mature. Or maybe when you're in the wrong, you apologize. It shows that you're like embracing your mistake. It shows maturity. And all these behaviors, all these things stem down to maturity. But the argument thing was the most like thing that I had would like catch people or make them like, no. I just want you to know that you won't gain anything from retaliating. You will not gain a single thing by responding to the other person. And you will both look like, I'm so sorry to say it harshly, you'll both look like idiots. Because, why? What's the whole even point? Both of you will gain nothing. It's petty, it's a waste of time. And I even saw this one thing that's like, if someone is arguing with you, and let's say they're like, you're so annoying, you can be like, that might be true, but hey, look, a cat. And if possible, they'll say, yeah, that's a nice cat. And you can say, then let's stop arguing and be friends. I've just solved your problems. I'm definitely going to try that. Maybe not with a cat, but it's something else. And hopefully it works. I can tell you guys later. Or you can try it if you're brave enough and post it in the comment section on how it went. Remember guys, maturity is important. Try to be the bigger person in what you do. Try to show Jesus in your actions. Ask yourself, like, what would Jesus do, in my opinion? Because I'm sure Jesus wouldn't say anything. My dad told me this story of, like, he was going to, like, from church with his guka, with his dad, my guka, and the house help that they had at the time, the sister was mad that they had chosen the sister over her. So she came and started insulting Guka, like, ah. Guka just stood there, waited for her to finish. When she finished, she ran out of steam. She's like, he just walked away. And that's the day, like, he realized that keeping quiet doesn't make you the weaker person. It makes you the bigger person. And how do you guys handle your arguments? I'd like to know, so please share in the comment section below. But thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed, please leave a like and subscribe. Share this video with your family and your friends so they can know, they can get the message. I'll push off to some of my friends. No, I'm just joking. But I'll see you guys next time. Bye.